System latency, button to pixel delay, and input lag are terms used to describe how responsive a game feels. And while it is very important that playing a game feels great, we want to know exactly how much time there is between an input and the result showing up on the monitor. So in today's video, I want to show you which testing methods I use to measure how different frame rates, frame rate limiters, features like VSync, reflex low latency, and many more affect the delay you experience while gaming. I will also show you how I test and compare the delay of various mice, keyboards, monitors, and the features they offer. In the past, I used a high-speed camera which is capable of recording 1000 frames per second, and a mouse which has an LED connected to the switch of the left mouse button. While this setup did produce accurate results, it is a very time-consuming process to measure the delay that way, as I must manually count the frames in the recorded high-speed footage to know how much time has passed between clicking the left mouse button and the action triggered by that input showing up on the monitor. NVIDIA's latency measuring tool called LDAT not only made this process a lot faster, it also opened the door to test more than just the time from clicking the left mouse button to the result showing up on the monitor. So what is LDAT? On the front, it has a 2-pin connector which you hook up to whatever triggers the input, like the switch below the left mouse button or a key switch on a keyboard. This connector is what LDAT uses to know that an input has occurred and it must start counting. On the back, which faces the monitor, we find a luminance sensor, which measures the brightness of the pixels it looks at. So when I place the sensor where a muscle flash shows up on the monitor, then LDAT detects when the pixels change their brightness, and it knows that it must stop counting. On the side, it has an USB port, so that it can transmit data to the LDAT software. You can run the LDAT software on the same PC as you do your tests on, but I always use a second PC because I can see the results in real time then. And I can be sure that the software does not affect the PC that I'm testing on. So LDAT doesn't know anything about the hardware of the PC you are testing. It's basically a stopwatch which starts counting when an input is detected on the 2-pin connector, and it stops counting when the luminance sensor detects a brightness change on the monitor. With LDAT, I can easily do 100 or even 200 samples for a single test, which not only leads to better results, it also enables me to show you how spread out or stable the measured delays are, which was simply impossible with the high-speed camera method. So, when I test how responsive a game is in general, or if I want to find out if the devs added an intentional trigger delay to a gun, or when I test a frame rate limiter, or how a new feature like reflex low latency affects your gaming experience, then I do not care about the delay of the mouse switch itself. So for that kind of test, I connect the 2 pins on the LDAT directly to the PCB of a mouse, so that LDAT detects when a mouse click occurs. This setup also allows me to take use of LDAT's autofire feature, where it will short the wires and so trigger the input on the PCB of the mouse. And yes, I did verify that the autofire mode does not have a negative impact on the measured delays. When I compare different mice, then I am interested in the entire end-to-end delay, which includes the mouse switch. This means that I must measure the delay from the moment the mouse switch gets pressed to the result showing up on the monitor. For that, I had to build this device, which uses a linear solenoid to always press the mouse button with the exact same force. And that is essential, as otherwise your measured delays will be useless. So, to get LDAT to detect that the mouse switch gets pressed, I connect its pins to these two contacts. When they touch, LDAT starts counting, and it stops when the luminance sensor detects a change in brightness on the monitor. Now, which software I run on the PC depends on what I'm testing. It might be a game where I measure the time from clicking the left mouse button to the muscle flash showing up on the monitor, or I might use a specialized program where the monitor goes to white when an input is detected. When I use this setup, then I will always explain in the video what software I used. So with that machine, I can measure the entire end-to-end delay from the mouse click to the photons leaving the display of the monitor. But it also allows me to test keyboards and compare how different switches affect the end-to-end delay, which I actually already did in one of my recent videos. But we are not just pressing buttons and keys while gaming, we also move our mouse. So I had to figure out how I can test how much delay you get when the mouse sensor is involved. So I built this machine, which also uses a linear solenoid to push a plate and so make sure that it always applies the exact same force, which is essential to get valid results. The mouse is suspended above a plate which sits on what used to be a camera slider. One of the two LDAT pins is connected to the tip of the linear solenoid. The other is connected to a piece of copper on the plate which gets pushed. Once these two contacts touch, LDET starts counting. As soon as the specialized software receives data from the mouse sensor, it will display a bright white image, which gets LDET to stop counting. So that is how I measure the delay of the mouse when it starts to move from a standstill. Now how about the delay when it changes direction? For this I had to slightly modify the setup. The linear solenoid still pushes the plate, but the contacts which tell LDET to start counting are now on the other side. There is one contact on the sled and another on the end of the slider. When these two touch, LDET starts counting and the sled bounces back in the opposite direction. The specialized software used for this test will only turn the screen white when the mouse moves in one specific direction. So the screen will only turn white when the plate moves from right to left, which allows me to measure the delay when the mouse changes directions. So how accurate is this method, which means how long does it take for the plate to change directions? When we examine this recording, which was shot at 1000 frames per second, we can see that the contacts only touch for a single frame. This means that this method doesn't add more than 1 millisecond of delay, as the plate below the mouse almost instantly changes directions. And that's it! This is how I test the end-to-end delay. If you have any questions, then please leave a comment and stay tuned for my upcoming video where we will take a closer look at the delay difference between using a mouse in wired and wireless mode. I also want to thank my fine patrons for their awesome support, which allows me to come up with new test methods and produce content that, as far as I'm aware of, you won't find anywhere else on YouTube. If you enjoyed this video, then please give it a like, subscribe for more, ring the bell to get notified when I upload my next video, and I hope to see you next time. Until then, have a nice day and take care. My name is Chris, and this was Battle Nonsense.